A very good morning to you all. Today we'll discuss about the experiment simulation of wireless channel estimation. We are discussion about the wireless channel estimation. The theory that we have discussed in the PowerPoint presentation itself. Now we are going to discuss with the help of the MATLAB program. So this is the MATLAB coding for the channel estimation in the OFDM system. So a paper is presented in this with the help of the paper quoted here. The coding is written. Just I will explain the coding, how we have to process the channel estimation in the OFDM system. At last we are going to calculate the symbol error rate in the OFDM system. First, for that we are declaring that training sequence. The training sequence has generated to assume the BPSK modulation technique of the symbol plus one or minus one. We are generating the series of bit sequence x zeros of 64 by 64, and we are generating a random numbers. Now the x of I comma I is nothing but d of I. This is the training sequence that we have generated. Now we have to generate the channel matrix. The paper which is based on this one is a channel estimation in the OFDM system. In this it is explained that least squares and minimum mean square estimations, the 16 QAM modulation technique. So we have assumed 16 QAM modulation in the OFDM system. This is the baseband waveform system block diagram. The signal x is passed through the IDFT, then through the multiplexer and D2A converter through the, now the G of T, the generation matrix is generated, G of T matrix is generated, the channel matrix, and the noise is has to be added into this. Then the reverse process is done in the baseband OFDM system. So for that we have to generate the sequence. That is what we are discussing here. Now the channel matrix G is generated. Now the fractionally the spaced taps are selected as a TAU, and will be generating the S as a signal, and we are generating the G of K using this S. The formula is shown in this equation, right? Y is equal to DFT of this sequence, because we are generating the endpoint discrete time Fourier transform signal. And here, this G of T, the channel matrix is evaluated. Then we are applying FFT for that. Now the XFG signal, that is, we are multiplying the X with the channel matrix H. This is what this equation says. We have to multiply this, right? Y is a signal with noise added. X and F has to be multiplied. Then it is added with the noise signal. That is a zero mean Gaussian noise vector has to be added with the convenience. The matrix notation is followed as n, y is equal to x into fg plus n. That is what it is generated. Now, the y is the signal generated, x fg plus noise. This is a vector. That is, I am showing the equation. This is the equation. And the corresponding coding, the same thing is written in the coding, right? Now we have to calculate the autocovariance matrix of the generator matrix of G or GG. The autocovariance matrix has generated this RGG as in the paper, because we have to calculate. See, the RGG matrix has to be generated to evaluate the LS and MMSC. Then there's an autocovariance matrix generated. Now we have to move on to the least squares and minimum mean square error algorithms. For the evaluation of the H matrix of the least squares, this is the equation for the least squares. HLS is the inverse of the X matrix multiplied by the Y matrix. And we have to generate the HLS matrix. This is the HLS matrix. Now the MMSE LSE estimator, the HLS is nothing but X inverse into Y. So inverse of the X matrix we have to calculate and multiplied by Y, we will get the HLS estimator structure. This is what the equation says, HLS structure, inverse of X into Y. Similarly, this for the HMMSC equation, we need to calculate what is RGY, what is RGG. So for that, we have to first calculate the F, the FFT of the signal U, the random signal generated as a U of a size 64 by 64. Then we are obtaining the total factor for this, 64 by 64. Then we have to calculate the HMMSC. The HMMSC equation is shown here. So this is the HMMSC equation, that is nothing but F into GMMSC. GMMSC is nothing but RGY, then RYY inverse into Y. So the cross correlation and autocorrelation, the functions RGY and RYY we have to generate. Then we have to substitute in the GMMSC. Then using the GMMSC, we can calculate what is the structure HMMSC. Frequency domain MMSC, estimate HMMSC equation, that is what shown here. The same equation is written as a code. Now we can calculate the symbol error with the help of the channel estimated. For the real-time simulation, we are just keeping the value of the SNR to 5 to 10 dB. That will be better for that. That we have to initialize the error count, then we have to generate the data vector through the channel, then the noise we are generating it to mix with the original signal that we have generated. Additive white Gaussian noise, complex Gaussian noise is selected. Now we will get the receiver signal as the Y with the help of added noise. Then the LS estimator based receiver is the code. Then MMSC estimator based receiver, the error count we are adding it. Now we will discuss about what is the signal to noise ratio. The signal to noise ratio is observed from 5 to 10 decibels. In the estimate, is the error count as initialized. Then for the least squares and minimum mean square error, we are going to plot the graph of in the semi-logy SNR versus the symbol error rate of the MMSC and the LS. So the plot gives you what is the symbol error rate for the least squares and the minimum mean square error. This is the signal estimate based receiver for the LS. The error count is initialized, then it is given in the loop through the slicer. This is the MMSC estimator based receiver. Using the HMMSC, the error count has passed to the slicer. This is the error count. Now we can plot the signal to noise ratio curve. Yes. I'll just run the program. This is the plot of the least squares and minimum mean square error estimator based receiver for the OFDM system. In the paper also it is described the symbol error rate. So the symbol error rate generally represents the mean square errors in the channel estimated. This is the average signal to noise ratio versus the symbol error rate. The curve in the semilogy, generally it is described in the semilogy curve. The semilogy is used to express the error systems. For example, 10 power minus 2 means one symbol error when 100 symbols are transmitted. 10 power minus 1 is 1 by 10, that is one error for 10 symbols, and one error for 100 symbols, that is 10 power minus 2. This is the corresponding symbol error rate curve. It's a theoretical one. In the simulation, as also we are getting the same curve, which is similar to the theoretical representation. So for the base, the paper is mentioned in the code top. This is the base paper. From this base paper only, the code is written using this base paper. It is mentioned in the code, starting of the code. It is mentioned in the top of the MATLAB code, the paper it is mentioned. I hope you will understand about the least square and minimum mean square error estimator. Thank you.